Hello and welcome to this tutorial. I'm Robin from DxO, and in this video I want to explain what's new in the Nik Collection 7. Control points have been in the Nik Collection for years, making it easy to create complex selections. You can see what's being selected by turning on the mask view. Now we know the areas in white are what will be adjusted. Later, DxO extended this technology by adding control lines. These use the same powerful U-point technology to make selecting large areas of an image easy. New in the Nik Collection 7 is the ability to make control points elliptical in shape, as well as rotate them to position them precisely on the image. To further extend these capabilities to every situation, we have the new Polygonal Tool. Use this to add points to select an area of the image. You can then position the sample point before refining the selection that's created. In addition to the new U-point tools, the Nik Collection 7 introduces luminosity masks for maximum control over your selections. Like with the U-point tools, we can choose to view the images we're editing or the mask. It works by selecting the luminance we sample in the image, but we can also manually choose from 11 zones, and even refine the selection manually for precise tonal selections. The Nik Collection has always been easy to use, and the Nik Collection 7 continues to incorporate new workflow improvements. With the Nik Collection 7, you'll experience a significant boost in efficiency. Opening images for editing is now up to 30% faster, saving you valuable time in your workflow. Another handy new feature is the ability to switch between tools using the switch button at the top of the interface. If I edit the colours in this image using Color Effects Pro, I can now switch directly to Silver Effects Pro to convert it to black and white. After applying my changes, I can see this has created multiple layers in Photoshop, one for each of the plugins I used. Let's look at the new Quick Export feature next, which you can access from the top of the plugin interface. After applying a preset to this image, I can use the Quick Export button to export the image to the same folder as the original. Now I'll apply a different preset, after which I'll use the Quick Export feature again. Checking the folder containing the original image, we see the two new images I exported. If I open the new images, we can see and compare the effects of the two presets I applied. Many of the Nik Collection plugins contain a wide range of filters and presets. The categories and favourite features can help you quickly find what you're looking for. In the Nik Collection 7, this has now been further enhanced by a new search bar. Let's use this to search the Color Effects Pro filters for Viveza. Now we can see there are three filters from Viveza, bringing us to another new feature in Color Effects Pro. We can use the adjustment tools from the Viveza plugin inside Color Effects as they've been added as filters. For example, we can add a white balance adjustment to this image and use it to warm the light. What makes this so useful is that it allows us to apply the white balance adjustment selectively. By adding a control line, I can choose to only have the bright areas of the image affected, leaving the background unchanged. The HSL filter in Color Effects has also been improved. You can see its power if I sample the colour of the light falling on the lady's face. Notice this sample appears as a range on the colour strip. Now I can reduce the saturation of the sampled colour, and even change the hue to change the feel of the image completely. To discover all the new features of the Nik Collection 7, visit our website, nikcollection.dxo.com, and try the Nik Collection for free.